death of General Qasem Soleimani is one of the most significant developments in the Middle East in the last 20 years. Many are saying that this action has taken the United States to the brink of war. Calling from Dallas, Texas now to explain what could come next is international relations expert Yvonne Davis. Yvonne, good morning. Thank you very much for joining us.
Good morning. Good morning.
Several questions for you. I want to start with a very quick one here. In your opinion, does this action by the United States make us safer or less safe?
I think at the moment, if we look at the reports on security, the security levels have been raised to a maximum level at this point. So anywhere Americans are traveling abroad, particularly in the Middle East region, the State Department has issued travel warnings to leave Iraq in places where there would be a potential for Iran to attack America. Is very high, and even the United States of America. So we need to be vigilant and observant of what's happening right now. This is a very serious time we're in.
Yvonne, you mentioned that cyber attack, and the most recent information does suggest that that's what they may be planning. What might a cyber attack mean for the nation?
Well, you have to remember, General Soleimani spent a lot of time as the chief military architect to increase cyber warfare. Although Iran's capability, still comparatively speaking to the U.S., Russia, or China, is still rudimentary, it's still very effective. Actually, Iran had a wake-up call when Israel and the U.S. teamed to covertly knock out Iran's nuclear program in 2009. And so they have invested considerable dollars in its hacker force, and it was able to test its capability in 2012 at the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, knocking out 30,000 computers, disrupting Saudi Aramco's export capabilities of crude oil. For the United States of America, one of the ways that would impact us would be attacking our American banking system. And things that there was a successful attack on a dam in New York State as well. So we need to not be asleep about the capabilities of Iran as they ramp it up. Also, too, what people don't talk about is the connection between Iran and Russia, Russia uses Iranian hacking infrastructure to get things done as well. So it won't just be potentially other proxy war attacks against targets in the United throughout the Middle East, which are 7 targets throughout the Middle East, including Israel. We're looking at also cyber capabilities and that type of intelligence.
Come to this, but how does the United States military stack up against the Iranian military, and what may a war between those two nations look like?
The United States of America is the most powerful military in the world. If you're doing stack for stack, the United States would crush Iran in a war. However, when you look at capabilities, Iran is the 14th largest military in the world and the 4th largest in the Middle East. So they have, since the United States pulled out of the Iran nuclear deal in 2018, they have ramped up their missile defense program. So it's not a matter of always might that wins. They are like the gnat that keeps coming and coming and coming. And an example of what they did on New Year's Eve and what they've been doing since October 28th, there's been 11 attacks by Iran. And so what we have to look at, Colin Powell used the pottery bond statement, if you break it, you own it. There's a successful assassination. Nobody misses Soleimani at all. But now we have a situation where the destabilization of the Middle East could take place if we do not get a hold of some sort of strategy that pulls Iran back to the table. Right now, sending more troops, we're ramping up when we were going to originally ramp down. So that is the concern right now. So we need to be awake and aware. It has nothing to do with our capabilities militarily because we are superior.
All right, Fox 61 will, of course, stay on top of these latest developments out of Iran. International relations expert Yvonne Davis. Yvonne, thanks so much for your insight. All right, you can expect continuing coverage on this developing story out of the Middle East. Stay with Fox 61 as we bring you the